Mile High Apple Pie by Laura Langston, illustrated by Lindsay Gardiner. My grandmother lives with us now because she can't remember. She's not the wrinkled kind. She's the special kind instead. She wears trainers with yellow laces and she laughs very loud. Once she had a houseboat with an art gallery by the sea. Then she played the piano and made mile-high apple pie. Now she sits in her special chair and rocks, quick, quick, quick. Dad says that one day Grandma's remembering will go away forever. She will forget everything, even our names. He is wrong. Grandma still reads me stories. Only now I help her with the words. We still go outside to play, and Grandma still talks to the birds. We giggle and laugh and sing special songs together. When Grandma gets mixed up, I tell her it's time for a nap. I keep her company while she rests. Some days Grandma jumps when her very own cat lands on her lap. "And who are you?" she asks. "That's Princess Pepper," I say. "She loves you very much." I feed the cat and comb the tangles out of her fur. She keeps my grandma warm. After school, I practice the piano. Sometimes Grandma nods her head and doesn't say anything at all. Other times, she tells me how well I have done. "Excellent, Margaret," she says. "Chopin would be proud." I give her a hug. I was playing Bach, but Grandma can't remember. Grandma still plants sweet peas in spring. "They are the only flower worth growing," she says, "because they smell so wonderful." The flowers grow tall and pretty. I cut a huge handful and bring them inside. I put them under Grandma's nose. "Smell." "Lovely," she says. "Roses are my favorite flower." She rocks her chair. Quick, quick, quick. Princess Pepper jumps down. "It's okay," Mom whispers when she sees me frown. "She loves them anyway." In the autumn, Grandma helps me pick apples to make pie. "I like those pears," she says. "I must pick them for my purse and put them in preserves." I giggle. "They are apples, Grandma. They are for our pie, remember?" "No," she says with a frown. "That's okay," I say. "I'll remember for you." Dad bakes her favorite mile-high apple pie now, and Grandma helps. "Peel them this way." She shows me how to take the skin from the apple. When I cut away the bruise, Grandma stops me. "The bruise is the best," she says. "All the sweetness in the apple rushes to the soft brown bit." Dad laughs, but Grandma insists. "I remember," she says. "A fruit man told me once." We keep the bruised bits in our mile-high apple pie because Grandma remembered. Grandma likes to take Princess Pepper for a walk. Sometimes I go with them. Grandma remembers lots of things, like steam trains and milk carts and rationing. But she can't remember the way home. Yesterday she went into a neighbor's house by mistake. Grandma's remembering is getting worse. One day after school, Grandma is in her chair, rocking quick, quick, quick. She smiles at me when I come close. "And who are you, my dear?" At first I think she's teasing, but then I see that look on her face and I know. My head goes all whooshy. My eyes start to sting. Grandma can't remember who I am. I go to my room without giving her a hug. Grandma's brain is all mixed up, Mom says as she rubs my back. But she still loves you, even if she can't remember your name. Now I let Mom take Grandma for walks. I practice the piano when she's not around. Sometimes I wish I could crawl into Grandma's lap like Princess Pepper, and other times I wish Grandma didn't live here anymore. One day, Grandma leaves for a week. "We need a break," Dad says. Princess Pepper stays behind. She prowls and meows and can't find a place to settle. I have three friends over at once, and we make lots of noise. Mom makes spicy chips and pepperoni pizza, the things Grandma hates. But no one sits in that special chair and rocks. Quick, quick, quick. Grandma comes back on a sunny afternoon. She sits in her chair and pats Princess Pepper on the head. I watch her and wonder, will she know me today? She pulls me close. "Hello, my dear," she says. "Do you know who I am?" I ask. Grandma's eyes look confused. Finally, she laughs. "You are my sweetness, the one who brings me flowers and plays the piano. You are my apple-cheeked bruise girl." At first I don't understand, but then I smile. I am like the sweet bits in Grandma's mile-high apple pie, her favorite food. I push Princess Pepper over and crawl into Grandma's lap. "I am Margaret," I say. "I am your remembering."